We're making sure that the entire package makes as much sense as possible for the needs of Canadians and for the needs of our economy.
Hundreds of Indian students are staging protests in Canada against the new federal policy that puts them at the risk of deportation. The new immigration policy has left the future of more than 70,000 student graduates in uncertainty. Indian students have been camping in front of the Legislative Assembly in Canada's Prince Edward Island province, while Canada's Ontario, Manitoba, and the British Columbia provinces are also witnessing similar demonstrations. What is the new immigration policy? Canada's new immigration policy proposes to reduce the permanent residency nominations significantly. Government's target is to reduce permanent residency nominations by 25% amid the local housing and job crisis. As per experts, Canada's new immigration policy is a result of rapid population growth over the last few years. According to figures from the federal agency, around 97% of the total population increase in Canada was a result of immigration. Canada is hoping it can solve its jobs and housing crisis by limiting this growth by cutting down permanent residency nominations. Securing a permanent residency in Canada was one of the key routes through which Indians were able to secure a stay in the country. With the recent amendments, work permits will be denied in areas where the unemployment rate is 6% or higher. However, these changes will not apply to agriculture, food processing, construction, and healthcare sectors.
These are ongoing conversations that we're having that we're taking extremely seriously. Obviously, over the past number of years, from the pandemic to the massive labor shortages immediately following the pandemic to the situation we're in now, we need to keep making sure we're responding to the needs both of Canadians, of businesses, and of the economy in general. And that's why we're constantly adjusting and making sure we're meeting the moment every step of the way. This fall, we'll be presenting for the first time an immigration's levels plan that doesn't just talk about permanent residents, but also talks about temporary residents, whether it's foreign workers or others. And we're making sure that the entire package makes as much sense as possible for the needs of Canadians and for the needs of our economy. That's why the first steps we're taking today of reducing the number of low-paid temporary foreign workers that can come work in this country is part of the response. Over the next 90 days, we'll be looking at the higher wage streams of temporary workers, and we'll be looking at unemployment rates and opportunities to make further adjustments over the course of this fall as we come forward with comprehensive level plans that'll respond to the reality that Canada's facing now and in years and decades to come.
This is likely to impact lakhs of Indian students aspiring to move to developed Western countries who have traditionally used the study visa route. As per federal immigration data, the number of Indians who have moved to Canada in the last 10 years has quadrupled from just 33,000 in 2013 to nearly 1,40,000 in 2023. Indian immigrants are the largest group of those seeking permanent residency in Canada. In January earlier this year, Ottawa had also announced a cap on the international students, saying it was being used as a backdoor entry to Canada. Another major concern for international students and temporary workers is the expiration of work permits. After completing their studies, many international students are eligible for a post-graduation work permit, which allows them to gain work experience. However, this permit is time limited, usually lasting between 6 months to 3 years. If students are unable to secure permanent residency within this time frame, they face the possibility of having to leave Canada. So as the protests continue to unfold across the country, the Canadian government faces mounting pressure to address the concerns of international students and temporary foreign workers. However, without any significant changes or rollbacks, many of these students will be forced to leave.